Ministry of Finance secured money through domestic borrowing without parliamentary approval.
As Parliament continues to scrutinize the 2023-2024 National Budget Framework paper, the Minister of Finance is in the spotlight for allegedly borrowing 2.28 billion shillings that was never approved by Parliament.
Then there should be an appropriate sanction that should be provided by Parliament.
The matter was brought to the attention of the Parliament's Committee of Finance this week by the Otuke County MP Paul Omara, quoting the report by the Minister of Finance on budget performance.
If the Constitution says that Parliament has the power of appropriation, that power should remain with Parliament and not with anybody else.
Omara accuses the Finance Ministry of abusing the budget process by tinkering with domestic borrowing to acquire loans that are non-sanctioned by Parliament, hence worsening the public debt burden.
The interest rates are very expensive, and then go more for concessionary loans. But going forward, we would not want to see the Minister of Finance abuse the budget process.
However, the Minister of State for Planning, Amos Lugolobi, was quick to deny the allegation, citing a parliamentary resolution that okayed the borrowing of the said extra 2.28 billion shillings.
Parliament resolves.
Yes.
2,049.74 trillion.
Yes.
Out of the total amount in supplementary expenditure number one for the financial year should be financed by government through additional borrowing from the domestic market. I certify that this resolution was passed by Parliament on 18th November 2021.
The Finance Committee chairperson tasked the minister to lay on table the said resolution, but however, it wasn't easy for the minister to surrender the document, saying the accusing MP must table his evidence leveled against the ministry before they can respond adequately.
Lay the resolution you have on table, we look into the matter, and if need be, we'll call you back on the issue. I think let's have the resolution you have.
Ministry is being accused.
But that
and
is
the person who is accusing, I thought that we have a right to access, the evidence of the allegation.
Honorable Minister, is laying your resolution conditional?
We can give it, but it's only fair.
Okay.
That we get the one.
Let's
from
see
that
what
side.
Whether it, when we check. That's what we are going to check. Yeah.
You know, I'm always very skeptical right now with the resolutions of Parliament. In my possession, I have a resolution that was altered. Eh? Altered.
But the Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, intervened and suggested that a committee of two MPs and two ministry officials be set up to investigate the matter.
Two people from this side and two people from this side.
Yes.
The question is not you are right, you are wrong. No. The question that we are working for our country and we must work within the law. If we have made a mistake, we apologize and we made a mistake.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.